Cheetos curls.
Things that are puffy.
Oh my God!
From Hollywood, this is the $100,000 Pyramid. Tonight's celebrity guests are from Jeopardy, Ken Jennings, and television host and personality, Ross Matthews. And here's your host, Michael Strahan.
Oh, welcome to the $100,000 Pyramid. Get ready because we've got games to play, stars to meet, and money to give away. It is go time. And first up, oh boy, we have a former Jeopardy champion who is now hosting the show. Who is Ken Jennings? That's who we got here, Ken. Hey, thank you for being here, man. I feel smarter just by shaking your hand. I just want you to know that. And you know, you won over $4 million on Jeopardy.
Guess that's right.
Can we play a little round before we get started here?
Should we do Jeopardy and then Pyramid?
Yes.
I love it.
Do Jeopardy and then Pyramid. Okay, the subject is food item. Okay. Ken Jennings never leaves home without this.
What is maple syrup?
Really?
I know it's weird.
Yes.
I love diner food. I love cheap diners. But I don't like the fake pancake syrup, so I always have like a little like flask of real maple syrup in my glove compartment of my car, just in case.
I never would have thought that. So, Ken, who are you playing with today?
This is Hannibal from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Hannibal, I feel like I'm seeing double because we have twins here, and we do practice, like do some practice games in the back. I was told by the producers that you and your brother gave the exact same clues. So do you share a brain?
I often find when I go to parties or I'm meeting with coworkers, I'll go up and start talking to them, and then they'll say, hey, your brother just made the exact same joke. So we share something.
Oh, well, hopefully you both are sharing some money. Mm-hmm. But it's not going to be easy to beat your brother out of the money that he might win because he's playing with my man, Ross Matthews.
Hi.
Hey, Ross.
Hi. You give Ken Jennings. Are you kidding
Ken
me?
Ken Jennings, hey, Ross.
The best? Are you trying
we
to kill me?
We put the best with the best, man.
Understood.
You can handle this. Trust me.
Ooh.
And you know, since you were here last time, you're recently married. Congratulations.
I'm married. I got married, yes.
So who are you playing with?
Oh, I'm playing with Malcolm from Pittsburgh.
Malcolm. All right, you heard Hannibal. He said you two share the same brain at times. But how competitive are you with each other?
I like to say may the best man win, but we both already know who that is.
I like it. I like it. This is getting good already. We haven't even started playing the game yet. Are you guys ready to go?
Yes.
Oh, I got to say good luck to everyone. And this right here, that is the winner circle. That's where you go to win the big money. But in order to get there, you have to conquer this pyramid. Here are your first six subjects. Here we go. We don't talk about Uno. Forget you haters. Am I white or am I white? Zoom, there it is. I'm not married to this. You're in trouble now. All right, Hannibal, Ken, you're up. Hannibal, what are you two like?
You know what? Let's go with you're in trouble now. Why not?
We all do it?
You do.
It is the number one clue.
All right, Hannibal, describe to Ken these places you probably don't want to be when nature calls. Let's put 30 seconds on the clock. Ready? Go.
It's where you, when someone dies, it's what the
funeral
event you have.
Yeah.
It's what happens in an office when everyone's gathered together. You're having a
job meeting.
It's where you go to get your license. You
have DMV.
You paddle in one of these.
Canoe.
It's where the Pope lives in
Vatican,
Rome.
Vatican City.
It's you run one of these, 26 miles.
A marathon.
It's where a bunch of people are gathered together having sex.
An orgy.
Right.
Very nice. I've heard.
I'm still tripping off the high five after you got that last one right, but that's good. Hey, perfect seven. That was quick, too. Good job, you guys. Way to get off to a good start. All right, Malcolm and Ross, what do you like?
In honor of the recent event, let's go with I'm not married to this.
Oh, thank
all
you.
All right.
Is there going to be an orgy in this one? We're you ready for it.
We only usually do one orgy a show.
Understood.
All right, Malcolm. Describe to Ross these less than romantic things that are often part of a wedding. Ready? Go.
The person who's married to your aunt.
Your uncle.
The bride wears this over her face.
Veil.
When it's taking a long time, what are you doing?
You're wasting my time. You're...
What am I doing? I'm tapping my foot.
You're checking your watch.
Pass. They're skin-tight leggings.
Spank.
You put this in to keep your pompadours.
Hairspray.
It's not better, it's...
Worse.
You do this, the funky one.
The chicken.
What am I doing now?
Dancing.
All right. The one that you did not get when you're doing this and it's taking a long time, you are waiting.
Waiting.
You're waiting.
Okay.
All right, Ken, what are you and Hannibal like?
I have no illusions about my reputation. I'm going to go with am I white or am I white?
There you go.
somebody had to do it.
I love it, man.
Gonna take one for the team.
Take one for the team. Describe these words that can follow the word white. Ready? Go.
Not in, but...
out.
The holiday in December 25th.
Christmas.
I'm going to bake some banana.
Bread.
This is my...
collard.
The piece in chess that can jump.
The knight.
The Chicago white...
socks.
The American...
flag.
That was good. That was good, man. Ross, Malcolm, you're up. What do you like?
Forget you haters.
Yes, please.
Was that directed at your brother?
I'm not going to pretend it wasn't.
All right. Ross, describe these praiseworthy words that are 8 letters long.
Okay.
Ready? Go.
Not negative.
Positive.
A brilliant scientist.
Einstein?
Yes. I'm an eternal...
optimist.
Oh, isn't that...
cute. Adorable.
I'm always on time. I'm...
prompt. Punctual.
I give so much. I am so...
generous.
Yes. I'm utterly... I'm kind. Everyone likes me. I'm the...
cheerful.
Prince.
Charming.
I wasn't talking about me.
You're charming enough so that you're down 1 point going into the final subject, which means you two get to pick first. So, Malcolm, what do you like?
Let's go We Don't Talk About Uno.
All right. We Don't Talk About Uno. Describe these words you probably wouldn't hear in a household that hates card games. Ready? Go.
It's what you do with the
shuffle.
Deck to make sure it's distributed. Good. Blank or no blank with the suitcases. Howie Mandel.
Oh, deal.
Yes. You mix it with tonic.
A gin.
It's Batman's enemy, who's a clown.
Oh, Joker.
You have to be this old to drink.
21.
You burn these with your friends who you're estranged from. You
Bridges.
Cross one.
Bridges.
Yes. You take off your clothes when you're playing this.
Strip poker.
Yeah.
I'm just curious. Ross, have you ever played strip poker?
No, but I'd love to. Thank you for asking.
Okay. You got that really quickly, so I was just wondering.
Well, Ken got orgy quick, so hey. I'm just saying, if we're using that logic.
Good point. All right, Hannibal, one subject left on the board. I'm going to let you read it. What is it?
Zoom, there it is.
You need 6 to tie, 7 to win, and go to the winner's circle. Describe these words you often hear on Zoom calls. Ready? Go.
It's you're on...
mute.
You're in the Zoom, this area.
Room.
They're the person who's in charge of a party. They are the...
your host.
I'm not able to move. Let it go. The
frozen.
You do this when you have something and you're giving it to other people. You are...
distributing, offering?
You do this with your screen. You are...
oh, sharing.
You can change this thing that's...
your background.
Not the beginning, but the
end. Ending.
Whoa! You did it! You did it with 2 seconds to go! Hannibal, Ken, come on, get out of those seats. Come get these seats in the winner's circle. And when we come back, Hannibal and Ken are going to play for $50,000. We got a great game of pyramids. Stay right there. Welcome back to the $100,000 pyramid, where Hannibal made it to the winner's circle, where he and his celebrity partner, Ken, are about to play for $50,000, my friend. All right, Hannibal, $50,000 is a lot of money, quite a bit of money. If you were to win $50,000, what would you do with the money?
One thing I love to do is take my family to this incredible experience in Japan where you get to dress like video game characters and drive these street legal go-karts through the streets. So, love to do that.
Really?
Yeah.
Man, I'm learning something new on this show every day. All right, that's awesome, man. Let me tell you how it works. You're gonna give Ken a list of clues that fit each subject. If you're given a legal clue, you're gonna hear this. Don't stop, keep on going. And if you get stuck, you can say pass. We'll come back to it if we have time. And if you get six right in 60 seconds, you're gonna win $50,000. Just that simple.
Right.
All right, Ken, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling confident. This is like my favorite part of the show. This is like a dream for me to be here. I'm gonna win this guy some money.
Well, you know I love it. So we're gonna put 60 seconds on the clock. And Hannibal, for $50,000, here's your first subject. Go.
Kick, whinny, neigh.
Animal noises? Horse noises.
Eat hay.
Things horses do.
Paris. Arc de Triomphe.
Things in Europe. French things.
There are 7 days in me.
What a week might say.
Orange, cranberry, apple.
Juices.
Welches. Escape prisoners. Extremely discounted items.
Things.
Escaped prisoners.
Things that are released, things that are.
And entirely discounted things.
Things that are free.
An octopus. A watch's body.
Things that have hands, things that have arms.
Yes!
You did it! For some reason, I was just about to guarantee that Hannibal was gonna win $50,000, and he did it. So congratulations, Hannibal, for winning $50,000. We're gonna find out if Hannibal can get back to the winner's circle to play for $100,000. But his brother Malcolm, I'm sure he wants to make it here instead. We're gonna find out if that happens right here on Pyramid. Stay right there, everybody. Welcome back to the $100,000 Pyramid, where Hannibal just won $50,000. And Hannibal, if you can make it back, you're gonna play for $100,000. If you make it, you're gonna play for $50,000. And we switch things up. Hannibal is now playing with Ross, and Malcolm is now playing with Ken. Here are your next six subjects. Here we go. Too much booty. Harry Styles. How I fled your mother. I'd like to speak to the manager. You're so full of cap. It's gonna be a long, hard D. All right. Behind one of those is a mystery seven. If you get the mystery seven, you get all seven right, you will win a relaxing vacation. All right, Malcolm, you are up. What looks good to you?
It's gonna be a long, hard D. No comment.
All right, here we go. All right, Malcolm, describe these lengthy words that all start with the letter D.
I'm glad I'm receiving.
Let's put 30 seconds on the clock. Ready, go.
It's the last month of the year where
December.
Christmas is celebrated. You use laundry, Tide is
detergent.
A type of, you look for the in the dictionary for these.
Definition.
It's not the same, it's.
Different.
It's the this of independence.
Declaration.
It's a movie about something that truly happened.
Documentary.
I need some water because I'm.
Dehydrated.
There you go.
Whew. Tough category.
That was good. All right. Hannibal, Ross, you're up. Hannibal, what do you like?
I'd like to speak to the manager.
I just work here, man. All right. All right, Hannibal, here you go. Describe these words a sports writer might use when interviewing a baseball manager. Ready? Go.
We didn't lose, we
won.
It's not lose, but
win.
There's seven of these in a baseball game.
Innings.
It's not a double, it's a
triple.
It's the month with Halloween.
October.
It's when you are switching something with someone. You're making a
transaction.
We have cards. What kind of cards we have?
Playing cards.
No, we're
trading
we're,
cards.
I got hurt. I have an
injury.
I hit it out of the park. It's
a home run.
All right, there we go. All right, you two.
Thank you for getting me there.
All right, Ken, what do you and Malcolm like?
I'm in the mood for too much booty. You want to do it?
I'm always in the mood for too much booty.
All right.
I feel like I'm hearing a conversation between two people I should not hear. You know, I'm always in the mood for too much booty. All right. All right, Ken, describe to Malcolm these things a pirate might have a lot of.
Okay.
Ready? Go.
Not silver, but...
gold.
Yeah. The bird on his shoulder?
Parrot.
He reads a treasure...
map.
He drinks a bottle of...
rum.
He fires a big...
cannon.
He doesn't have friends, he has...
enemies.
On his knees or his elbows, he might have
a patch?
A square of cloth. There we go.
That was a perfect 7 again, 14-7. Ross and Hannibal, come on, you two. Ross, what you like?
How I Fled Your Mother, please.
Okay, here we go. How I Fled Your Mother. Ross, describe these excuses you might use to get out of meeting your new boyfriend's mother.
Okay.
Ready? Go.
Not a cat, but a...
dog.
You are not awake, you're...
you're asleep, you're tired, you're boring.
Oh, a big, bad headache.
Migraine.
Call 911 because it's
an emergency.
When you get up in the morning, you go to...
you go to work.
Seasonal...
allergies.
I'm having a baby.
Pregnant.
Whoa, okay. All right. You're not gonna meet your...
oh, wait, yeah, you're
mom's
pregnant.
Gonna talk about, I'm pregnant?
Oh, I'd love to meet your mother, but I'm pregnant.
All right, you guys, we got a tie game. Malcolm and Ken, you are up.
Let's go with you're so full of cap.
All right, Ken, describe these words that contain the consecutive letters C-A-P. Ready? Go.
James T. Kirk is the...
captain.
You drink a coffee drink. It's a...
it's cappuccino.
Italian, yeah. I'm going to get out of prison. I'm going to...
escape.
Tropic of the... the
Capricorn.
Sign of the...
yeah.
This is my...
patella,
It's got to have my... what part of this is it?
Kneecap.
Yes. The boat's tipping over. It's going to...
capsize.
Cut off my head. I'm going to be...
decapitated.
Yeah.
Wow.
Sorry, I thought I screwed that up.
No, you're good. You
wow.
Made my heart jump with that one. Another perfect 7 right there. 21-14, Ross Hannibal. Need a perfect score to keep up.
Yep.
And we know there's one subject left on the board. We know behind that subject, which is Harry Styles, is also the mystery 7. If you get all 7 right, you're going to win a trip to Cancun, Mexico.
Ooh. All right.
All right.
Okay.
Ready?
Yes. Go.
Not tall, but...
short.
Bees make this sound.
Buzz.
It's when you cut your hair off except for this thin strip in the middle.
Mohawk.
You can... it's when you have these.
Sideburns.
It's when you twist it up. You
can braid.
It's when it's really puffy. It's
bouffant.
Like a 70s style.
A beehive.
A black sort of 70s
afro.
Style.
Afro.
Yes. It's if you have a lot of long hair, you can tie it up.
Ponytail.
I'm a guy, so I have a...
but hair, man bun.
There you go. You did it. Oh! You did it. And you won the Mystery 7, which you won the trip to Cancun, Mexico. They're going to tell you all about it.
You've won a 7-night all-inclusive getaway to the beautiful Wyndham Alltra Cancun. Situated in Cancun's lively hotel zone on a spectacular stretch of sand, this family-friendly resort boasts sprawling pools, a full-service spa, and 10 incredible bars and restaurants. Plan your perfect all-inclusive getaway at WyndhamAlltra.com.
All right, congratulations, Hannibal.
Great work.
And those were all ways of wearing your hair. That's what they had in common.
Yeah, yeah, I figured that.
And we have a tie. 21-21. The way we break a tie, which team got to that point total in the quickest amount of time, we'll go to the winner's circle.
Okay.
And that team is... Ken and Malcolm.
Oh, my God.
I thought they had a six.
So close.
Come on over, you guys.
So close.
When we come back, Ken and Malcolm are going to play for $50,000. We'll be right back with more Pyramid.
Hold on.
What's in the category?
Welcome back to the $100,000 Pyramid. My man Malcolm, he made it to the winner's circle. Well, he and Ken Jennings are going to play for, you read it, my friend,
$50,000.
$50,000, a lot of money. Now, your brother was here, did very well. He told us what he would do with $50,000. What would you do with $50,000 if you were to win?
Well, first, I'm going to win it better, but I'd like to take my family on a yacht trip around the world. And as a lactose intolerant food scientist, I'd like to get my revenge by trying as many exotic animal milks along the way as I can.
Wow. You and your brother have some exotic things going on, man. I love it, though. I'm learning from both of you. And Ken, back in the winner's circle, how you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I want to win them each $50,000, make Thanksgiving nice and not awkward, you know?
Yeah, that could be a little weird in the household if we don't get that done. But we're going to start right now. Let's put 60 seconds on the clock. Malcolm, for $50,000, here's your first subject. Go.
The steering wheel.
Parts of a car.
GPS. Fly rod, bait.
Fishing stuff.
I am the person you elected to lead your city.
What a mayor might say.
Your glad bag, your hefty bag.
Things you put in the trash?
Tampons, knee ones.
Pads.
Your couch, a thick blanket.
Things that are cozy, things that are cuddly.
Yes,
we did it!
Yeah.
And you beat his time!
What? That was so insane! Oh my goodness! Congratulations to Malcolm! He's just won $50,000! Congratulations to his twin brother Hannibal, who won $50,000! Ross, thank you! Ken, thank you! Hey, thank you guys at home for watching! But don't go anywhere, because the $100,000 pyramid, it continues with more great games, new contestants, and two of your favorite celebrities, and it all starts right now.
The $100,000 pyramid continues. Our next celebrity guests are from the Emmy Award-winning RuPaul's Drag Race, host RuPaul, and Drag Race judge Carson Kressley. Once again, Michael Strahan.
Let's keep it going, people. We are serving up realness tonight. So let me introduce our first celebrity. Say hello to fabulous drag race icon, RuPaul.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
Great to see you.
Good to see you. I had so much fun the last time I was here.
You're very competitive, I know.
Hey, you know, it's Hollywood, right? You gotta be competitive.
But now you're going against your friend Carson.
I'm gonna kick his butt.
Oh. All right, who are you playing with today to help kick his butt?
Well, Hiko is here.
Yes.
How you doing, my friend? I heard that I helped you out recently.
Yes, I recently had to go to a wedding, and I realized my old suit couldn't fit. I ran to the store in a panic. And I found this gorgeous royal blue stylish suit. I look inside, it's from the Michael Strahan collection. So thank you for making me feel like royalty.
You know what? I'm glad I was able to help, but buttering me up ain't gonna help you win any money, guys. I want you to know that. But we got a good game, you got good competition. You're playing against a man who's hilarious, and he is always perfectly dressed. Carson Kressley. Carson, how you doing?
I'm great, how are you?
I'm doing fantastic. You know, I heard you know how to make it hot in the kitchen.
I do. I did take up a lot of baking during the pandemic. One of my most requested are slutty brownies.
And why are they called slutty?
Probably they're called slutty because they're easy.
Hey, Carson, who are you playing with today?
I am playing with the lovely Christine from Brooklyn, from the BK.
Christine, you're here with two amazing stars. So what are you going to do to impress them?
Well, I could drop into a splits at a moment's notice. Do you guys want to see?
Oh, yeah.
Gosh,
yeah.
Yes, all right, let's do it.
Wow.
Now that you pulled my arm.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, that was really good.
Wow.
Now, Rue, you do it.
Okay.
You guys are always fun. Great contestants. Y'all ready to go? Y'all ready to have some fun? All right, good luck to everybody. Let's get started with these six subjects. Here we go. Ooh, you're in trouble. Weak in the knees. Talk nerdy to me. Saved by the jail.
Ooh.
Bye, Felicia. Let's see how big this D can get. All right, Hiko, RuPaul, you're up. What do you like?
we have to go with, and we have to see how big this D can
get. Absolutely.
I love that.
All right. Going straight forward.
Okay.
All right, describe these words that start with D that get progressively longer and longer. Oh. Let's put 30 seconds on the clock. Ready? Go.
Not wet, but...
dry.
Yes. Not shallow, but...
deep.
Yes. Not mommy, but...
daddy.
Yes. These in my cheeks when I
dimples.
Smile. Yes. Oh, when I graduate college, I get a...
diploma.
Yes. I'm gonna make a strawberry...
daiquiri.
Yes. Oh, I pine after you. You're so...
delicious.
You're so loved. Everyone wants you.
You're so desired. Desirable.
Yes.
Oh! Yes!
Wow.
With 1 second left, and you like, delicious.
I want to see how big that D could get.
Oh! All right, Christine, all Carson, right. What do you like?
Let's do talk nerdy to me.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, describe these words smart people might use as their safe word.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
Go.
Oh, this is Isaac Newton's When an Apple Drops.
Theory of Relativity, Gravity.
Yep, mm-hmm. When you blow into a balloon and it floats up the gas inside.
Helium.
Yep. This is what you point when a cat plays with it. It's
a laser pointer.
Mm-hmm. Pass this one. The blank of a circle, it goes around, you measure it.
The circumference diameter.
Mm-hmm. This is Lord of the Rings, is a lot of the small people.
Oh, gnomes, trolls.
When you knit a lot and you
crochet.
It was Hobbit. And the one you passed on was pie. Is that a good start? All right, RuPaul, what do you like?
We get the knees.
All right. RuPaul, describe these words such as knees that a chiropractor might use during the work week. Ready? Go.
This is something that you put jewelry around.
A neck.
Yeah. My back is my...
spine.
Yes. Chubby Checker had a big song.
Twist.
Yes. Black don't...
crack.
Yes. below my knee is my...
ankle.
Yeah, and it sounds like...
femur.
It sounds like this here.
Jaw, chin.
Yeah.
Shin.
Yes. Shoot. Oh, my goodness, I ran out of time.
You got 5 in that round.
5? That's all? Oh, my God.
All right, Carson, you're giving the clues. What do you like, buddy?
Saved by the Gel.
Ooh.
Okay.
One of my favorite shows.
Oh, yeah.
That's good. All right, Carson. Describe these things you can do to fix a bad hair emergency.
Oh, good.
Ready? Go.
A baseball cap is a...
a hat.
Mm-hmm. You cut with...
scissors.
I'm doing this. I'm getting rid of my beard.
Shave.
Yes. My shirt is wrinkly.
Iron.
Me... yes. And, I put this in my hair. It's a foam.
Gel. Mousse.
Yes. And, this is the 80s. It's like a ponytail holder, but it's...
pass.
Pass.
Plastic.
And, blank and seek.
Hide.
Mm-hmm. And, I put this to hold my ponytail holder. It's
rubber bands. Scrunchie!
Yes!
It's okay. We got a tight game. It's 10 to 12.
Okay.
You two are trailing, which means you get to go first. What do you like?
Can we do Bye, Felicia?
Bye, Felicia.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. Okay, Carson, describe these words close to Felicia in the dictionary.
Oh.
Ready? Go.
January.
February.
White picket.
Fence.
You throw a ball to your dog, you have
Christy.
Him. You
Fetch.
Have him, yes. And I take this boat, but I can put my car on it.
Ferry.
Yes. And Coachella is a...
festival.
Yes. And if you're hungry, I need to blank you.
Feed you.
Mm-hmm. And Gloria Steinem is a famous...
feminist.
Yes.
There you go! Very good. All right. You two are up. One subject left on the board. Go ahead and read it for me.
Ooh, you're in trouble.
Ooh, wait.
Channeling Tootie from Facts of Life.
All right. You need 5 to tie.
Okay.
You need 6 to win.
Describe these words you can make using just the letters and the word trouble. Ready? Go.
Not false, but...
True.
Yes. This part of my...
Lobe.
Ear. Yes. I'm gonna put on a bath...
Robe.
Yes. Teenage Mutant Ninja...
Turtle.
Yes. You blank, the website everyone watches videos.
Oh, YouTube.
Yes. Blank 66 to California.
Root.
Yes.
There you go! You did it! Come on over, you two! When we come back, Nico and RuPaul will play for $50,000. We'll be right back with Royal Pyramid. Great job. Woo! Welcome back to the $100,000 Pyramid, where Hiko made it to the winner's circle. And he and his celebrity partner, RuPaul, are about to play for $50,000. Love that, man. What would that do for you?
Well, I'm a huge horror movie fan, and I have so much memorabilia, I would love to convert my home office into one big pop culture library.
Wow. I love that. Well, you got a good partner. All right, you two ready?
Yeah.
Yep.
Let's put 60 seconds on the clock. And Nico, for $50,000, here's your first subject. Go.
Spot, Bud.
Names of dogs.
Yes, yes. I'm a ice cream delight with syrup and whipped cream and cherries.
Sundae.
Typing.
Things web you do searching, with your fingers.
Web searching.
Things you use the
emailing,
alphabet for. Things you use on a computer.
Yes. Packing, shipping, taping.
Things you use bubble wrap for. Things you put in boxes.
Receiving letters.
Oh, things you need a post office box for.
Sending letters.
Things you need
receiving, postage
stamps.
Oh,
things
stamps.
Why you, things to do with mailing things.
Postage stamps, skip, pass.
Things you lick?
Brazilian body.
How about babies, doctors, a pregnant mom?
How do you prepare for a baby?
Delivery. But it's okay. And then
room.
You said Brazilian, that was for waxed things.
Yep.
But you know what? You won $6,000.
Yeah.
Nico, if you can make it back, you'll play for $100,000.
We'll make it back.
When we come back with more of the $100,000 Pyramid, so don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the $100,000 Pyramid, where Hiko just won $6,000. And if you can make it back to the winner's circle, you'll play for $100,000. Then we switch things up. Hiko is now playing with Carson, and Christine is now playing with RuPaul. Here are the six subjects. Here we go. I ink, therefore I am. Oscar the couch. My martial arts instructor is Sensei Shino. Nip slip. Here we go again. Hey, baby. I got a cavity that needs filling.
Oh, my goodness. Ooh.
Let's just see how big that D can get.
Yeah. Okay,
so
here
sorry.
We go. Now, behind one of those, the Mystery 7. If you pick the Mystery 7, you get all 7 right, you will win a fun-filled vacation. Okay? Christine, RuPaul, you are up. What do you like? And I am so afraid to ask that.
Well, I got to go with my martial arts instructor is Sensei Chanel.
Okay, Christine, describe these things associated with martial arts.
Oh, wow.
Let's put 30 seconds on the clock. Ready? Go.
This is where Tokyo is, the country.
Japan.
This is the Japanese martial art. This is the blank
Kung
kid. But the blank kid with Jackie Chan and Will Smith's son. It's
the Karate Kid?
Yep, mm-hmm. This is what you do with vegetables.
You chop them.
Mm-hmm. Self blank. You go to a self blank
defense.
Class. Yes. Mm-hmm. This is the guy in Karate Kid. The
instructor.
The instructor. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, it was Mr.
Miyagi.
Yes.
All right, you got four. Miyagi. You got a good start. Hiko, Carson, you're up. What do you like?
I'm going to go with Oscar the Couch.
Okay. The Mystery Seven.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, if you get all seven right in 30 seconds, you're going to win a trip to Turks and Caicos.
Oh, I love it there. We'll have so much fun.
Yes, we will. Yes. We're totally going.
You two ready?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Ready? Go.
Oh, I'm doing right
now. I'm crying.
Now. Yes. Black and white.
Tuxedo.
Yes. The Oscar blanks are?
Nominations.
The people.
Ballots. The contenders.
A form of that.
Nominees.
Yes. Live from the?
Red carpet.
Yes. All the actors make up the blank in the movie.
The Academy, the cast.
Yes. The symphony, all the?
Orchestra.
Instruments.
The soundtrack.
Yes. Blank Streep, actress.
Meryl.
Yes.
Damn,
you
won your trip to Turks and Caicos,
oh my gosh, we're gonna have
tell
so
them
much
all
fun.
About it.
You'll spend 6 days and five nights at Beaches, Turks and Caicos Resort Villages and Spa. Enjoy spacious family accommodations, exclusive concierge service, unlimited five-star global gourmet dining, white sandy beaches, thrilling water parks, and the best land and water activities. Beaches Resorts is the luxury-included vacation for generation everyone.
All right, Hiko, enjoy that, my friend. And you know, let me tell you what all those things had in common. Those are things you might see while watching the Academy Awards from home. Great job there. All right, Christine, RuPaul, you are up. What do you like?
Yeah, let's do Nip Slip.
Nip Slip.
All right, RuPaul, describe these signs your cat has a serious catnip addiction.
Okay.
Ready? Go.
Oh, the sound that cats make. The other sound.
Purr.
Yes. Oh, when spit comes out of their mouth.
Oh, froth, foam, slobber.
It sounds like when you play billiards.
Pool?
Yeah.
Drool?
Yes. Yeah. It makes a sound that sounds like a snake.
Hiss?
Yes. They do this with their tongues.
Lick?
Yep. This is they will look at you for a long time. That's called.
Stare?
Yeah. And this is the, okay.
All right, you got five.
Okay. Wow. Five?
Yeah, you got five out of seven.
Okay.
You like, okay, like
no, that. I thought I did much better than that.
All right, 9-7, Carson, Hiko, what do you like?
Hey, baby, I've got a cavity that needs filling.
What?
That just rolls off the tongue
it
for me.
It certainly does.
All right. Okay, Carson, describe these words you might hear in a dentist's office or in the bedroom. Ready, go.
Not the bottom.
Top.
Mm-hmm. Not the top.
Bottom.
Mm-hmm. This is my...
mouth.
Mm-hmm. And when you fill a cavity, you use this tool.
Drill.
Yes. And...
bite.
Yes. And that really hurt.
Pain. Ow.
Yes. And saliva is?
Drool.
Another word?
Salivating. Spit.
Yes.
Woo! I love it. 14-9. Christine, RuPaul, you need a big round here.
Let's do I ink, therefore I am.
All right, here we go. Describe these words that contain the consecutive letters I-N-K. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go.
Oh, this is what a pig sound makes.
Oink.
Yep. Oh, God.
Stink.
Yep. Mm-hmm. An ice blank. This is where you, in Rockefeller, this is where people
skate. Rink.
Yep. This is when you blank glasses. It makes that sound.
You clink.
Yep. When you go big and go tiny, 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 honey,
shrink.
I blank. Mm-hmm. Blank like little star.
Twinkle.
Yep. Mm-hmm. BDSM. I want whips and chains. You are.
A dominatrix.
I am like the adjective. I am blank. I love feet. That's my.
What about boots? Broadway
Kink.
Show.
Kinky.
Kinky yes. Boots.
Yes, yes.
Ah, 14-15.
Mm-hmm.
Carson, Hiko, you need one to tie, two to win. If you can do that, you're going back to the winner's circle to play for $100,000. Okay?
No pressure.
Who's going to give the clues?
Carson, would you like to go?
Oh, sure. I'll be a giver. Okay. Switch it up.
Yeah, why not?
try something new.
Why not?
That's what I say.
Here we go again. All right, describe these words that often follow the word French. Ready? Go.
This is bread. When you put it in a machine, it makes it brown. No, bread. It's a breakfast treat, yes. You enter a room through a...
door.
Yes.
There you go. Yeah. Oh. It. Come on,
that was
you
already?
People, oh my God. They are coming to the winner's circle, where they're going to play for $100,000. You don't want to miss that. They're right there. Welcome back to the $100,000 Pyramid, where Hiko made it back to the winner's circle. Well, he will play for you. Go ahead and read it.
$100,000.
$100,000. So we talked about what $50,000 would do. What would $100,000 do?
Well, my mom and I had a pretty rough year, and I would love to take her on a dream trip. We're going to go on the Orient Express.
But I tell you what, you two are a great team. Carson, how you feeling?
Oh, I feel good. I'm excited. And I want to go on the Orient Express, so let's do this.
All right, you're fantastic at this game, so let's get it done. We're going to put 60 seconds on the clock. And Hiko, for $100,000, here's your first subject. Go.
The flight attendant.
People on an airplane.
I'm a machine with levers and a silver ball, a wintry landscape.
A snowscape.
A basket, a picnic, food.
Things at a picnic. Things a horse would say.
A wet one.
Things you keep in your purse when you have a baby.
A sports one.
A bra. Different types of bras.
A sports one. A dive one.
A bar. Types of bars.
Yes.
Well, you said ball. And that was one of the words in there. You said picnic. And those are things at a picnic.
I said picnic.
So we can't, of course, use words that are already... in the title there. But you know what? Hiko, you won an additional $12,000. You add that to the $6,000 you won earlier. You won a total of $18,000 and a trip to Turks and Caicos.
Oh, yeah.
Christine, thank you so much for playing. RuPaul, thank you. Carson, thank you as well. And everybody at home, thank you for watching. We're going to see you next time on the $100,000 Pyramid. It's all good. 18 grand, man.
Yeah, that's not bad. We're still going to Turks and Caicos and Jerusalem.